Hey, this is Dylan from SlickText. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to start using the Workflows feature. Workflows is a tool that allows you to create automated processes within your SlickText account. You can create custom journeys for your contacts, saving you time and making your marketing more personal and effective. Workflows can send text messages, collect information, update contact records, change inbox statuses, and much more. In this video, we'll take a tour of the Workflows tool and then build a simple workflow together. Click on Workflows here on the left. This page will show you all of the workflows you've created. Let's create a new workflow together that will collect the email addresses of new subscribers. There are all kinds of great templates for workflows that you should check out. There is a template for what we're about to build, but let's start from scratch for the sake of this video. First, name and write an internal description for your workflow. This will help you in the future know exactly what this workflow does without needing to click into it. I'll call this email collection. For description, I'll say asks new contacts for email. Next, choose how often contacts can be entered into this workflow. I'm going to select only once ever, since I only want my contacts to be asked for their email address once. All right. Now let's start building. Every workflow needs a trigger that will initiate the automation to commence. There are all these options here. I'm going to use Contact Created, because each time a contact is created in SlickText, I want this workflow to request that contact's email address. Just drag and drop the object you want into the canvas. Every object you use will need to be configured to fit your needs. So let's click the gear wheel to configure our contact created object. I'll select the creation sources that should be included and click save. Now I'm going to head to the conditions tab. Conditions check the status of something before moving forward in the workflow. I want this workflow to send a text only to new contacts who didn't provide an email in their opt-in method. For example, if they opted in through a web form that asked for their email, I don't need to send them a text asking them what their email address is. If they joined by texting a keyword to my number, all we would know about them is their phone number, and I want to make sure I get their email address as well. We can use the contact field matches condition to check whether or not we have this contact's email. After dragging in my condition object, we'll configure it. For the field dropdown, we'll select email. For condition, I'll use has no value, meaning the email field for that contact is empty. After saving the condition, I'll drag the arrow for my trigger to this condition object. Every object you use should have an arrow pointing to it, showing the path you'd like your contacts to take. At this point in the workflow, I want a text message to be sent, asking for the contact to reply with their email. Let's go to Actions, and you'll see what actions can be taken by the workflow. I'll use Send Message. Now, when you go to drag your arrow from certain objects, you'll be able to split the path depending on how you configure that object. This is a simple yes, the email has no value, or no, the email field does have an email stored in it. I'll use yes and connect it to the Send Message object. Let's compose the message we want to send out. I'll call it email request, and then type out reply with your email address to get a special offer in your inbox. Then hit save. I'm going to head over to the waits tab because now we want the workflow to wait for a response from the contact. I'll drag and drop the message received object and click the configure icon. Do I want to look for certain data in the inbound message? Yes. What we're looking for is an email. If it finds an email in their message, we want the workflow to save it to the email field. We'll have contacts wait in this object for 1 day. You could customize this workflow to ask again for their email if they didn't respond. But for this example, if they didn't respond after 1 day, they'll just be removed from the workflow. Now I'll hit save to finish configuring this object. Let's connect the previous object to this one. Notice that you have these other options in case the workflow couldn't send the message, like the contact isn't subscribed to receive automated messages from you, or you ran out of text credits for the month. I'll go ahead and connect the objects for when the message was actually sent. Our options after this wait object are email found, email not found, and message wasn't received. If the email was found, let's send a thank you message and ask them to keep an eye out for an email we'll send soon. So I'm going to quickly add that here. If an email wasn't found, I want to assign the conversation to a member of my team who monitors the inbox and drag and drop the Assign Inbox Conversation object. I'll configure it to assign the conversation to Chris and hit save. Now I'll connect the objects to create the path I want my contacts to take. The thank you message if an email was found in the response, and assigning the inbox conversation if they responded, but an email wasn't found in their response. I'm going to collapse this sidebar so we can see the full path of the workflow we created together. When a contact is created, they'll pass through this condition to check whether or not they have an email stored. If they do, they'll just get dropped out of the workflow. If they don't, and the email field is empty, they'll get the text message asking them to reply with their email. Then, the workflow will wait up to one day for a response with their email address. If they sent their email, it will store it and send them a thank you message. If they don't respond after a day, they'll get removed from the workflow. If they respond, but an email address wasn't found in their message, my team member Chris will get this new conversation assigned to him so he can see what their reply was and respond accordingly. Everything looks good to me here, so I'll set it to active and hit save. This is just one example of what you can do with the Workflows tool. There are so many other things that you can automate inside of SlickText. I recommend checking out our library of workflow templates to get some ideas of automations that you want to create. We have a great collection of other workflows-related videos and articles that you can check out inside of our Help Center. If you need any other assistance, please don't hesitate to reach out to our support team. We love to help our customers.